Hello everyone, my name is Jack Consenko. Welcome to my home. I wanted to show you a little space that I created in my home, which is like a coffee corner or a coffee nook. Ever since the lockdown, many of us couldn't go to our favorite cafes. And just like you, I enjoy a nice cup of coffee in the morning. I have a clean white shelf that has 8 compartments. And it's great because it makes something as mundane as a French press look sculptural. And it's within close proximity to the kitchen. So if I need water or the stovetop, it's nearby. And by creating a coffee corner in your home where you take out and display the different equipment that you have to make coffee, this will encourage you to use them more. It's also a great idea to add some of your favorite objects to create an ambiance that you like, such as books, artwork. I have this Ishinomaki bird that I really like, and also this mid-century looking ceramic bowl that I found at an estate sale in Makati. Nothing too cluttered. Artwork on the countertop or on the walls is a really great addition too. I like things clean and minimalist, so this Kagurazaka postcard framed in white actually works great for me. I personally enjoy just a strong cup of black coffee. I don't put milk or sugar, but if you like milk or sugar, definitely put that in your coffee corner. I also place my coffee corner near a table where I can do some work because I find that the smell of freshly brewed coffee is very conducive to working. So being able to read or work nearby is perfect. I'm not a coffee expert. I don't have a lot of fancy equipment, but I do have a lot of very common and very easy to use ones that you might already have as well. I have the beans, I have the coffee grinder, I have the coffee dripper, and a mocha pot. Now let's talk about coffee beans. I got these coffee beans from Sagada Coffee, and they're located in Teachers Village in Quezon City. I'm from QC, so it's very convenient for me to get from them. The coffee company has an initiative called the Coffee Heritage Project, which helps in the sustainable livelihood of the local coffee growers, which in turn conserves Philippine coffee heritage. And I have 3 types of beans here, and this is the Mira Bueno. Mira Bueno coffee is a 2019 Medai Gourmet Awardee and is a 100% Robusta from Bukidnon. It has a strong and full-bodied flavor with hints of chocolate, almonds, and caramel. This is the SGD coffee, which is 100% Arabica from Sagada. And it has a flavor profile of nuts and dark chocolate and a spicy finish. This is the Banas coffee, which is 100% Arabica from Sagada. It has a flavor profile of spice, Criollo, dark chocolate. Now we have 3 ways to make coffee with these beans. The first one is a coffee dripper, like this one. Basically, just put a filter on top. You place this on top of a mug. You put your ground coffee in here and you pour hot water very slowly on top and you wait for the coffee to drip into the cup. I have the French press here, which is one of the easiest and least time consuming method. Basically, you just put the ground coffee inside here. You boil water. You don't put boiling water on here or it will scorch your coffee beans. So you actually boil water and you let it sit for about a minute. And then you pour the water in here, push the plunger down, and you allow the coffee to brew. Now I have a Bialetti mocha pot, which is very easy to use. You just place, this comes off. And this lower chamber, as you just fill this up with water up to right under the valve here. And then you place the metal filter on top and you fill this with the coffee grounds and you screw this on tightly and you place this on top of a burner or a stove top and you wait for it to boil. Your coffee will actually build this top chamber up, and once that's full you can remove it from the burner and enjoy your coffee. By creating something as simple as a coffee corner or a coffee nook at home, hopefully it helps you relax and enjoy a cup of coffee.